After the introductory part of sericulture, our next point is external morphology of developmental stages of silk moth. These developmental stages includes egg, larvae, pupae, and adult silk moth. We start from the egg. These all four stages include the life cycle of silk moth. Okay, we'll describe here one by one. The first silkworm egg. Silk moth lay two types of eggs, diapause and non-diapause egg. Now we call hibernating and non-hibernating eggs. See these diapause eggs. Diapause eggs means what? So in which larva, embryo stop development at late gastrula stage. Yeah, it cease development. And in non-diapause eggs, the eggs hatches after the completion of pre-embryonic period. You see the structure of silk moth eggs. This is the central acetal eggs having a yolk centrally accumulated. This eggs is covered by chorion. Okay, see this chorion, and then after this chorion, there is a white line membrane, and there is a periplasma. At the end, there is micropoil through which the exchange of gases occur and nucleus at the periphery. So this is about the structure of, it may be diapause or non-diapause structure. This is the structure of eggs. Now, next is larvae of silk moth. See this morphology of larvae of silk moth. This larvae is called erusiform or polypore type larvae. Again here, like adult, the larval body is also divided into the three parts. One is head, second thorax, and third abdomen. Head is hypognathus. See this head of a sar silicone larvae. The head is hypognathus means what? Here, the head directed downwards. Then it is heavily chitinized and bright browny color. It is made up of six segments of body. Larva possesses biting and chewing type of mouthparts. Because larva is a voracious feeder and its main work is feeding. Okay, it possesses biting and chewing type of mouthparts. Next body part of larva is thorax. Thorax divided into three parts. Prothorax has a pair of respiratory opening called spiracle. Then second or middle part of thorax is called mesothorax. Mesothorax have dorsal eye spot. Meso and metathorax form a dorsal hump on the body. Each thoracic segment bear a two legs for holding mulberry leaves during feeding. And the last part, body part, is abdomen. 11 segments are present, but only 9 abdominal segments are visible. Each abdominal segment bears pair of prolegs. Yeah, this pair of prolegs present on the 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, and 9th segment. 8 segments have a projection called as caudal horn. First 8 abdominal segments bear a pair of spiracles for respiration. Then larva has number of projection or nodules on all over the body and marking on the skin. So these are the morphology of silicone larvae. Now if you want to differentiate the larvae of male and female silk moth, then see this sex marking in female and male larvae develop in 4th and 5th instar larva. See this female larva. In female larva, at the 8th and 9th abdominal segment, on ventral side, a pair of sex marks are present. See this 8th abdominal segment, the Isiwata 4 glands present, and at 9th abdominal segment, Isiwata hind glands present. In male larvae, at the junction of 8th and 9th segment, single opening called as Hallowed gland spreading. In adult, this Hallowed gland modified into seminal duct and ejaculatory duct. So this is about external morphology of this silicon larvae. Now next is the third stage, we call resting stage of adult silk moth development. During the development of silk moth is pupa. Pupal stage is resting or inactive stage. It unable to feed because it is covered by cocoon. It is transitional stage in silicon life in which larval organ diminish, remold, new adult organ are formed. Visible parts are compound eyes, a pair of antennae present, 10 abdominal segments from ventral sides. See this, we also differentiate the male and female larvae. See this female, male and female pupa. See this female pupa and this one is the male pupa. Female has fine longitudinal line on the 8th abdominal segment. See this female's pupa having a fine longitudinal line on 8th segment, and in male, the dot mark are present on, see this dot mark present on 9th abdominal segment. Now the next stage, last stage is adult silk moth. See this important characteristics, see this tarsal silk moth. Important characteristics of silk moth is it not interested in flight. It bear wings, but it not interested. It does not feed. And if we see the lifespan is very short days, near about 3 to 6 days. Size of moth is about 4 into 2 centimeter. And entire body, see this entire body and wings is covered by epidermal scale. Again, larval body, the adult body is divided into head, thorax and abdomen. See this head, small and hypognathous. We know hypognathous means the mouth part directed downwards. This moth head bears the prominent paired compound eyes. It possesses a bifurcated antennae and a non-functional coiled proboscis. Second parts of adult body, adult silk moth body is thorax. This thorax again here like a larval body divided into 3 segments. One first prothorax, middle mesothorax and last metathorax. Cuticle of the thorax harden to form sclerax. Okay, see this dorsal tergites. This sclerax name is dorsal tergites, ventral sternite, and lateral both side is called thorax. Meso and metathoracic segment bear wings. Pale colored wings bear scale. Each segment of thorax bear pair of legs. See this, we know in insects, like in silk moth, 3 pair of legs present and each legs consist of 5 parts, first coxa, second trochanter, then femur, then tibia and last tarsal. This tarsal bears claws. Last part of adult silk moth body is abdomen. This abdomen also covered with scale. 8 segments visible in male and 7 segments visible in female. So these are the distinguishing characteristics in male and female silk moth. This abdomen bears 6 pairs of spiracles. If you want to differentiate the male and female silk moth, then certain characteristics we consider. So this body size, female are generally larger than male. Then color, female is pale and male is darker in color. If we see the activity, female is less active as compared to male. Then female bears a pair of small antennae as compared to male. In abdomen, large and 7 segment present in female, and in male, 8 segment visible, but these segments are small. External genitalia also differentiate the both sex seeds in male. Caudal end has a pair of hooks known as harpen, and these harpen help during copulation. So these are the external morphology of eggs, larvae, pupae, and adult silk worm.